you are welcome to the show. I'm your host, Kamlamo Pearl Muriadi. Isivakashi sami sanamhlanje busuku saqala ukusebenza kuhlelo labantwana iOTV eminyakeni eminingi eyadlula. Manje ungumethili wezinhlelo kumabona kude. Njengamanje wethula i-fan base right here on SABC 1. Ungumlingisi sike sambona kukhululeka kanye ne-Tempi Pushers elingisa indawo kaNgolobe. Very interesting character that was. He has now branched out behind the scenes, becoming one of the most sought-after television directors representing Umtata in the Eastern Cape. Please put your hands together for my guest tonight, Akhumzi Jezile! Please have a seat.
Yo, Bushelana.
Hey. Bushelana?
Yeah, it's pretty.
Thank you. 10 years in, you are now one of the most sought after directors, television directors in the country.
Thank you.
Let's take you back to your big break on your TV. That's you.
Jeez. Ngiyaxolela ke mina kuba ngabuphelwe ngilaye ungayanga kweyiphinda soqala apha eJohannesburg i-event eyizigcigcigcwe abantu abahle izobe senza ka Essendon Convention Center. Kune email lana epink and the lover rishayo ithi wild beef subject ayo and ithi high five. Come great. High five. Low five. Small five. Shokanjalo. All right, asikhathi sokuthi sekunethelandela isikhathi sokuthi siye ku-World Guest Challenge.
What's up, South Africa? Nibukele i-Big Breakfast apha nqaphambili eMzansi for sure.
To be more than I can be.
Yes!
Yeah!
Right?
Yeah!
A massive throwback.
Actually, ndimhlekwe ndityebileyo. I don't care who says what. Yabona laa nto leyo umlomo ubungaka ndirayithi ngondinje.
You've grown into your own.
Yes, yes. Wow.
So then you do this, right? Completely out of the blue. And then God was just answering your prayers that you've been praying for many, many years. Impilo ishintshe kanjani after this?
Okay, so the thing othetha ngoku about God answering your prayers is that when God plants a certain vision in ngqondweni yakho, you are not aware of what God is doing. God planted a vision. That vision ought to clearly wear to toilet endlini. Ucinge yona when you're trying to picture a better life. That is God planting a certain vision in ngqondweni yakho. And the Bible says his promises are yes and amen. So when he plants that, he promises you this. Ne? Yours is to make sure, and he gives you the tools, pal. Uya iplanta lento athi na ukufamba yakhona nazi tools sebenza ke wena qinise kubuya fika pha. So he prepares you for this. He prepares you for a certain life. He prepares you for zonke lezinto lezi. But when awubikho aware when God asebenza ngawe ubona segqithi ukuthi oh man nansi lento lo muntu ebeyenza kume ebomini bam. So for me dangena phaya, and again another thing, and finally stressile uba xa kule industry lena it's easy for you to get a big head and be a balloon and wander around. Amanya ba balloon abuya se wapanchile, amanya wabuye at all. That's what happens. So I was so fortunate and so blessed that I didn't get a chance to get a big head. I wasn't better that I didn't get a chance to get a big head. I just never got the chance to get a big head. And I'm thankful to all those people who were real and genuine around me and kept me grounded the entire time.
We like that. Having said that, what do you think God is preparing you for now? Looking at what's happening in your life, kwamanje.
God has planted a vision in Tlokwenyam, and you're going to mark my words. I will run my media empire. I will run a media empire. And yonke into endiyenzayo ngoku, people around me sometimes banibona as someone that is constantly overworking themselves and overcommitting. Ngenza into ezininzi mina ngexesha eliyi-one. But how am I going to become a media mogul if I don't go past the stage? There's a lot of things in this endeavor at the moment, but it's collecting everything to be the person that I need to be. Remember what I said, that he gives you the vision, he gives you the promise, and he gives you the tools. The tools are what I'm using right now to get to where he actually wants me to go. And in the Africa.
We can't wait to witness this glory that you speak of.
Thank you.
Oh man. Thank you, bro. Man in the mirror, Michael Jackson.
Yes. A very strong message, Glangoma. As young people, we have a habit of constantly blaming the government, of blaming the world around us, and of always thinking about the world owes us something. The opportunities are there. The world is there. If Pearl is doing it, if Pearl is living that life, if Pearl is living her dream, a pillar breathing the same air any 24 hours a fan and a.m. Why can't I do it? So the change will always start with you.
Right.
You are responsible for your own destiny. Look at the man in the mirror. Utete naye, dila naye. The rest will fall into place.
You're also a motivational speaker, ne?
Sometimes.
Not to your sevens and German. Here's your song. Thank you, everybody. My guest tonight started off on kids' television and has grown in leaps and bounds since his days of innocence. We know that has changed completely. And he has since branched out to host a fan base like SABC 1, a TV producer, a director, Ngumlingisi, as well having bagged a SAFTA Award for Best Actor in a TV Drama alongside Bob Patrick Shai, Nolindani Nkosi, Kamalake, Akhumzi, Umgcina.
Yes!
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 Isho wena isho
ukabule khulu utyopho umgcini uqhamela nokwindla
yeah
ithakazelo zasekhaya
yes uwe loyo ne
Jezile strong
ne
dim yes
wena you have a strong relationship no mama akho
yes yes I do
ne
yeah I was raised by a single parent I've got two older sisters Siyana and Nosipho and I've got a little brother Ugcina and I think a lot of indlela le ngicinga ngayo has been influenced a lot by my mother. My mother is a go-getter and she pushes against the odds. If it's a no, no, that no will be torn into a yes. She decides uba ndizawuyenza le nto le. She doesn't have formal education wagqibela isikolo already pha kwa grade go grade 3 ezilalini encobo. But the person she is today you would not say. You would not say she motivates me, and if someone like her with that educational background uyakwazi uzimela elizweni la namhlanje abe kule ndawo akuyo right now arane a business zakhe kulandlela arana ngayo business so indlela acinga ngayo is the main reason why ndicinga le ndlela encinga ngayo is the main reason why ndibona ukuthi actually everything around me ndingakwazi uyenza as long as I decide mina
ne
yeah
Baba could didn't have a big influence in your life ngoba ashona osemncane
yeah
ne
but by blessing and by God's grace I don't think there's even a moment where I said elife ini yam I'm missing a father figure I don't know about ole dunala vibe is strong or nanga hay and has but I honestly cannot say ukuthi like ndahlala one night ndilila and sithi oh mna I didn't I had one parent. I have one parent. She's very strong and very present in my life.
Yeah.
That I forget that I die maliko.
Wow.
Yeah.
I know what it's something what you don't like going back to. But abanye abantu don't know the story. This is the story where you almost got hijacked in Melville. Ne? You thought it was a hijacking, but it wasn't really.
Yeah.
When's again?
So I stopped by SABC, a garage in the Tengi Petrol.
Yeah.
And then I was looking for a friend of mine, but I was driving in a residential area. But I was so obviously I was driving slow.
Yeah.
It was around December. I was driving slow. Pang about 7. Ne? The kaluba tak. And then the driver was slow. The next thing they got a stop sign. Festivuliwe. And then umdatiqinekan. And they pull me out of the car. Bavuli moto, they pull me motweni. But I don't know what happened, but now could be automatic. So you have to go on to park, right?
Yes.
So I think the go park. And then the Cooper next seat, but I had the keys on me. And man lahlela phansi and then batis katele yini ma tut I'm a celebrity. Nicaba nguti what do I and then they start kicking
you
me.
You are on the floor at
I'm
this
on the
point.
Floor. Yes. They're kicking me. And then bangene emotweni bakhupha izinto zonke semotweni. And then thathe isixo diphakame. And I wasn't aware by nezantoni. Dilahle isixo kule jardi lane that's close by. And then batile iski, asisibone iski. And then Natila sings Lahlela Pakwet.
The bravery.
I wasn't thinking then, no, you know. And then Bati is key. And then they tried looking for the key. They couldn't find the key. And I think they were running out of time. Baba like, oh, kuqitha amapolisa. I need to say this on TV. Kuqitha amapolisa. Amapolisa azanga ndincede. Kumnyama babaleka ahamba amapolisa. Yes.
Oh, ustaba amapolisa.
Bahamba. They did not help me.
But, yeah. but then you say you're feeling actually the South African justice system failed you.
It did. I'm not going to lie, it did. It did. And I'm not going to be a person that's sitting here and blaming the government. And we have a long way to go as a country, but we are from very far.
And with that said, I feel as though whenever you go through something or experience in doing a party, actually, you find solace in the Lord, in the gospel, in the Bible.
I do.
You know?
I do. And I do. But can I tell you about my favorite scripture in the Bible?
Yes.
Basically, my message, I think everything is stating already,
yeah.
is the ability of making things happen. That any situation that you are faced with, anything, we have vuka, uzjonge esipilini, decide bandiyayenza ngoku. The power of knowing. There's a verse in the Bible, Ezekiel 37. It's a verse about the valley of dry bones, where Ezekiel was asked by the Lord, if yakwazi ukubuyisa amathambo omileyo back to life. Ezekiel was commanded by the Holy Spirit to bring those bones back to life. Now, if Ezekiel had that amount of faith, he had that amount of knowledge of God. Remember what I said about knowing. He knew that much, he had that much knowledge and that much faith that he was able to command those bones to come back to life. What situation is worse than death? Yini esendlula ukufa. Yini esendlula amathambo omileyo ukuthi abuyele ephileni. Right? That verse talks about the ability of knowing. Ukuthi any situation that you are faced with namhlanje, ulala ungatyanga, ulala uvuke ekseni uye esikolweni ungena sihlanga uzonxiba esikolweni, it is you that has to talk life and speak life into your situation.
Yes. Yes.
Speak life into that situation. Look at that situation.
Yes.
And say, I command life. Those dry bones must come back to life. I'm getting a tattoo of that one day. I don't know where.
Where is it going to be?
Yeah, on my leg. I've got beautiful legs.
Oh, you do?
Ah, where?
You want to short? Yeah. Oh, what a powerful message. Thank you for that.
Thank you.
And the song that you chose, Joyous Celebration.
Yes.
You love Joyous Celebration.
You're
very close with a lot of gospel artists as well, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
I love Joyous Celebration purely because they make me happy.
Yeah.
I listen to their music, Mangkele Traffic on my way to work, ekseni ngijabule. And this particular song is a song ethathwe ku Ezekiel 37. And the songwriter here uthi khuluma naleso simo ngoba inkosi inamandla. Iyo le ngoma.
Naculo lakho Akhumzi. He wants to be remembered as a person who gave life. A scripture from the book of Ezekiel inspires him in this regard, and it's all about bringing dry bones to life. Usitshele kabanzi ngalesa scripture leso before the outbreak. Kamla ku Akhumzi Jezile, kanti namhlanje busuku sibungaza yena, and also celebrating a decade, an entire 10 years that has been in the entertainment industry. Welcome back to Zaziwa. But what's good to 10 years, Wenk?
Yeah, but like, more to 10 years, ngathi sengizoba uDr. Lillian Dube.
No. Ngoba kule
level, sengizoba kusimela ngibe uDr. phela namanje.
10 years is nothing, do you know that?
I know. It's like a minute.
Mam Lillian has been at this for how many years now?
Yo, Mam Lillian has been at it and she's so awesome. Hey?
Right?
Yo, she's so awesome. Yeah. Yo, I love her.
I was chatting to Mami Von Chaka the other day. She's been doing it for 32 years.
So, guys, so figure nini, so figure sibangakana and skin and get 10 years away.
Ah, suga.
Awa.
Mara wena. What would you say keeps you up at night?
Like, gives me sleepless nights?
That one constant thing that is always just nagging every single night before you go to bed, but you're at your most honest right before you fall asleep. What is that thing?
Sure, that's such a deep question, a lovely question. What keeps me up at night? What nags me at night? Dialala, brah, and I mean that in the most honest way, bro. Wow. Dialala. I'm just at peace. And I know that I can't control everything. And I know that I can only do so much. And I can't do beyond my means.
Yes.
And sometimes, ubonba, there's a big day tomorrow. There's big challenges. Isn't lindileyo ngomso. But right now, ndilapha. Manilale ngoku.
Yeah.
Ndiyalala.
Shoo. I strive to be at a place like that.
Lala again. Lala again.
So imagine,
you're going to ask me questions.
I'm going to ask you questions, but they're not my questions.
Okay.
We want to involve our viewers.
Okay.
On the show?
Yes.
So bathumela imibuzo yabo on social media, and these are the questions, right? Rebonex Mudisa Gang says, when do you plan on getting married?
I don't know. When do I plan on getting married?
Yeah. I guess, do you even want to? Is it something you think about?
I don't know how I feel about marriage, to be honest. I don't know the two minds about marriage. Sine journeys is different, our own journeys. And I'm going to write my life story the way I want to write my life story. And right now, I'm born and... If they are chatter, hallelujah. If I end the gang, I skipped.
Okay. Snazo Tando says, I've loved him since COTV and I still love him today. I like that he's always smiling as well and would love to meet him. I love you, Akhumzi. So, Lena, it's just a comment.
Thank you, Snazo. Thank you so much.
Not a question.
Thank you.
All right. Usboniso says, how do you feel about the gay rumors?
How do I feel about the gay rumors? I feel nothing. I feel nothing.
Okay.
I feel nothing. It doesn't move me. Whatever opinion you have of me, and I'm not, it's not even being arrogant, because it can easily be read as arrogance.
Yeah.
It's not even arrogance, but whatever opinion you have of me, angendawo, bra.
I don't think it's arrogant to say that.
Angendawo, like it's, I feel nothing. And I also would like to stress that people in this, South Africa and Mklanje, no one should be defined by anyone. No one should be boxed by anyone. Hate crime against homosexual people, hate crime against women, hate crime against children. Abuse comes from people who think a certain way. Don't be a prisoner of your own thoughts.
I know you want to clap again. I think we're going to be clapping the whole show today. So much wisdom.
Thank you.
Where did you learn to think like this? Ufuze bani kini umamako?
I'd like to think so, but I'm honest, Pearl.
Yeah.
I think songe siyazazi izinto zithethayo.
Yeah.
But I'm honest.
Yes, that's
true. Dikhetha mina uthetha inyani yami right now.
That's the truth about
and,
you.
And inyani yami sometimes ayizofihlala kakuhle kuwe.
Yeah.
And that's okay.
Yeah.
But inyani yami.
Ndiyakhuluma ne.
Strong.
And ukhuluma kamnandi.
Thank you.
And I love your music selection as well. So we're going to go to the last song we ukhethile namhlanje.
Yes.
Cheers to the weekend.
Yes.
Rihanna.
Yes. I like this song because life is too short to be sitting around miserable.
Yeah.
People gonna talk whether you do good or bad. So cheers to the freaking weekend. I'll drink to that.
Yes. Here's your song.
Love it.
Woo! One more time for my guest tonight, Akhumzi Jezile.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, nice song.
Yes, thank you.
Lovely chat. Thank you so much for coming here.
Thank you for the invite.
I think you have inspired many.
Thank you.
Including myself.
Thank you.
I will say it to you now, Wuti. Instagram page, you're going to post a...
Rubbish.
Yeah. Stop posting rubbish.
Okay.
At least like just a video once a week.
Okay.
I'm asking very nicely.
Okay, I'll try.
Just to inspire a lot of people.
Because
I know someone watched today and they needed to hear what you had to say.
I'll try. Thank you so much, though.
Please.
Thank
I think
it'll be like
it's just a testimony.
Thank you.
Of the greatness that God can do.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It is.
Abantu abaningi bakubekile manje Akhumzi, and they've been supporting you since 2007 when you started. Yini into ufuna ukuyisho kubo?
Enkosi kakhulu, ndiyabulela kakhulu nge-support yenu. Your support is what drives me. Your support is what makes me want to be better at everything I do every day. Nangomso, nenze kanje nakwabanye.
Okay, time for us to go. Kodwa ngiyazi ukuthi you are a presenter here in SABC 1 on Fanbase. You're also a SAFTA winning actor.
You must recognize.
Yes, I thought you were actually going to bring this after here, because when you won, you were taking it everywhere.
Yes, car wash everywhere. People needed to know.
Right? Yeah. Well, now we know. And hopefully you win one for presenting.
Yes.
Like you do on Fanbase. So you're going to do the closing for us before someone of Tanjangish.
Yes.
It's a yes from Akhumzi.
Yes, okay. Thank you so much for joining Pearl on Zaziwa. Another awesome week with myself, Akhumzi. Next week, she'll be hosting another awesome guest.
Mm-hmm.
I am out of here. Good night.
Ooh, bye.